Welcome students, I am very happy and glad to meet you all. Once again, welcome to the commerce class. I am your commerce teacher. Okay, now we move on to our topics. In last class, we have seen about management by objectives. The abbreviation is MBO. So we have seen the meaning, definition and objectives and the features. So objectives is the main thing of MBO, and definition also, and meaning we saw, and features we have completed. Now let us move on to the process of MBO, and today in this class we'll see also the MBE. Now we move on to the process of MBO. So the first point is defining organizational objectives. So defining the organizational objectives, that is, the objectives are to be framed by the top level employees. So in each company we have three levels of employees. They are top level employees, middle level employees and lower level employees. So the objectives are framed by the top level employees and towards, and it moves towards downwards to the lower level employees to be completed. So first the long run or the long term is framed. Afterwards the short term objectives are framed. So the objectives are framed by the top level employees of a company. The second point is goals of each section. Goals of each section, here objectives for each section, department or division are framed on the basis of overall objectives of the organization. So what will be the objective of an organization is to achieve the goal. So first, in first point we saw about the framing of objectives, that is framed by the top level, and two objectives. First one is the long term objectives are framed, second one is short term objectives are framed. Next we see and how it is given to each departments. It is separated and given to each departments. So we have, before this we have seen about the departments, that is production manager, sales manager, marketing manager. So all these departments, they are separated it and given to each department. So next, coming to the third point, fixing key result areas. Though the key result areas are fixed on the basis of organizational objectives. So fixing the key level areas, that is KRA, in abbreviation we say KRA, are arranged on a priority basis, that to indicate the strength of an organization, to know about the strength of an organization. So for example, we see KRA are profitability, market standing, innovation. So KRA is a key result area. That is, in this place, we have to achieve what we are going to achieve. So we have to find it from each individual. What are their strength to build up our organization, to make our organization to achieve the goal. So next one is setting subordinate objectives or targets. So the fourth point is setting subordinates objectives or targets. The first one we saw about the framing of the objectives, and the second one is the framed objectives towards the goal are to be separated to the each departments, and next one is to finding the key result area where we are going to achieve the goal. Next one is setting up the subordinate objectives or targets. So the objective of each subordinate or individual are fixed. It is preferable to fix the objectives in lower level in quantitative units. So I told you all, top level, middle level and lower level. In lower level, we have to fix the quantitative units. So, to be frank, free and frank discussion between a superior and a subordinate. If you have a superior and subordinate discussion between them, so it will be easy for the superior to find out the subordinates what are the things that they have failed in, and what are the things that they are not comfortable with in the organization to fulfill their needs. So these are the opportunities of the superior to observe the subordinates. So there must be a chance, there must be a discussion between a superior and a subordinate. Next one is matching resources with objectives. So the objectives are framed on the basis of the availability of resources. If resource is there, then the objectives also can be fulfilled. The framed objectives also can be fulfilled. For example, the resource is like, if the in a company, in an organization, if there is we have 100 computers, but the employees are only 5 employees, so we cannot fulfill the objectives. Another case also, if you have 200 employees but you have only 5 systems or 10 systems, so you cannot fulfill the objectives. The need is much. So resources also is the main thing. It can be a raw materials, or it can be a person or a labor. So this is the matching resource with objective. So what objectives we are framing, we have to match it with the resources also. So our resources are in need or to be clarified. Next one is periodical review meetings. So the meetings must be periodically reviewed between the superior and the subordinate. So should meetings periodically be reviewed, in which they discuss the progress in the accomplishment. What do you mean by accomplishment? Accomplishment means something that has been achieved successfully. So accomplishment means something that has been achieved successfully of objectives. So the objectives that has to be achieved successful, we have to maintain a periodical review meetings. The fixed standards may be changed in the light of progress. Next point is appraisal of activities. So important point, appraisal of activities. At end of the fixed period for achieving the objectives, there should be a discussion between the superior and subordinate. Before that, what do you mean by appraisal? Appraisal means an act of assessing something or someone. An act of assessing something or someone. So before you're going to have a discussion between a superior and a subordinate, you have to assess about that person. The superior has to assess about that person. What, how he is doing, how his performance is in the organization. So what are the problems to be identified from the subordinate, and how we can tackle it, and what are the steps we can take to solve the problems. So this is the appraisal of activities taken. Next one is reappraisal of objectives. So reappraisal of objectives means what? An assessment of someone or something again and again in a different way. If the first way where you did the appraisal for a superior to the subordinate is not satisfied, next he goes for the reappraisal. In that way, you have to think in a different format. How I can tackle this problem? And he can give some training for the person who has to fulfill the work or job. Why his work is not completed yet? What I can do for him? So these are all known as reappraisal of objectives. Okay. Next we move on to the advantages of MBO. So the first one is managers are involved in objective settings at various level of management. So you see here, MBO process helps the managers to understand their role in total organization. What is their role? How they have to be in an organization, and what are their ways to encourage the people. And the second point is MBO process helps the manager to understand the role in the total organization. And next is manager recognizes the need for planning and appreciates the planning. So he recognizes the need for planning and appreciates the planning. And next one is the MBO provides a foundation for participative management. Subordinates are also involved in goal setting. So the goal has to be set,
that only we have seen before itself in process to frame the objectives. So next one is systematic evaluation of performance is made with the help of MBO. And next one is MBO gives the criteria of performance. It helps to take corrective actions. What are the actions to be taken? It must be in a corrective format. And next one is delegation of authority is easily done with the help of MBO. So delegation of authority is easily done with the help of MBO. So next is MBO motivates the workers by job enrichment and makes the job meaningful. Job enrichment means making the person to the workers, the laborers or the subordinates to work and make them to make their job a meaningful one. Meaningful one means to make the job easier, not in a harder form, to make the job easier for them to fulfill the achievement of the goal of an organization. The next one is the responsibility of a worker is fixed through MBO. Next, we move on to the disadvantages of MBO. MBO fails to explain the philosophy. Most of the executives do not know how MBO works. So, if we must know about what the MBO is and what is the MBO is going to do for the company or an organization or a firm, how it works, we must know all these things. So this is the disadvantage. Most of the laborers or most of the people doesn't know. So what is MBO? First one is how MBO works, what is MBO and why is MBO necessary, and how participants can benefit by MBO. Next point is MBO is a time consuming process. So much time is needed by senior people for framing the MBO. I told you before itself, the top level have to frame a objective and they must have a conversation between the superior, that is from the superior to the subordinates. So all these things are time consuming process. So this is a disadvantage. And the third one is MBO emphasizes only on a short term objectives and it doesn't or does not consider the long term objectives. Most of the MBO is considered to be in a short term. And next is the status of subordinates is necessary for proper objective setting, but this is not possible in the process of MBO. The status of subordinates is necessary for proper objective settings, but this is not process of MBO. Next one is MBO is rigid one. Objective should be changed according to the change circumstances, external or internal. It is not done. The planned results cannot be obtained. Rigid one is they have fixed the object and they have the object and the goal, so they work towards it. They cannot change it in the between, so it is a rigid one. So there is no changing is made. They have to follow the same one. So these are the disadvantages of MBO. Next we move on to the meaning of MBE. MBE means management by exemption. So a management by exemption is a style of business management that focuses on identifying and handling cases that deviate from the norms. So, for example, a production manager establishes quality control standards wherein 5 defects per 100 units produced are permissible. So, if you are going to make a 100 dolls, out of 100 dolls, you can, they are giving you that 5 dolls can be defected. That is, sometimes you can make it with mistakes. So, 5 mistakes are allowed. So, other than long as the number of defects does not exceed. So, other than 5 mistakes, you cannot make more than 5 mistakes if they are saying like that. So, within 5 mistakes means the supervisors or foreman can take the problem, can handle the problem. Otherwise, if it is more than the 5 mistakes or the 5 defects you are making, then it should be reported to the production manager. So in this case, you have to report to the production manager. manager. That is management by exemption. They are giving the exemption for 5. If you make more than 5 mistakes, you have to go and meet the manager, production manager. So next, management by exemption is the practice of examining the financial and operational results of a business and only bringing issues to the attention of management if results represent substantial differences from the budgeted expected amount. Next, we move on to the advantages of MBE. What are the advantages of MBE? So the first one is it saves the time of a manager because they deal only with exceptional matters. So the manager has to deal only with the matters. That means more than 5 defects are there, they have to deal only with that problems and that mistakes only they have to deal. So it is one of the main advantage. They no need to talk to all the subordinates or to all the laborers, those who are perfect in their work. The second point, it focuses managerial attention on major problems. As a result, there is a better utilization of managerial talents and energy. And the third point is, it facilitates delegation of authority. Top management concentrates on strategic divisions or decisions, and operational decisions are left to the lower levels. It is a technique of separating important information from unimportant one. So what are the important information they have to take? Other than that, they will not consider. Next one is MBE keeps management alert to opportunities and threats by identifying critical problems. It can avoid uninformed and impulsive action. So they no need to follow all the workers and to result, to show them the results and all and their performance and all. Next one is management by exemption provides a better yardstick for judging the results. So it gives a super judgment. It is helpful in objective performance appraisal. Next we move on to the disadvantages of MBE. So we have completed the advantages of MBE. Now we go going on to the disadvantages of MBE. So the main disadvantage of MBE is only managers have power over very important decisions which can be demotivating the employees at a lower level. So but in MBO it's not like that. The superiors can frankly or free to talk to the subordinate lower level peoples and they are very free. But here the managers have the power, decision powers over the important decision which they are taking. So this demotivates the employees or the lower level persons. Furthermore, it takes time to pass the issues to managers. Managing employees who deviate from the normal procedures because of compliance failures are considered difficult to manage and typically find themselves with limited job duties and ultimately dismissed or terminated. Here, if the work is not up to the level, that is, I told you all that if the mistakes or the defects are more than 5, maybe like 10 or 20. So here in this case, they are sometimes dismissed or terminated from the job because their duties are not followed. But in MBO, it's not like that. They give some time for them to, they give again the training. They help them to realize their faults and their mistakes. So these are the disadvantages of MBE. So we have completed the third chapter also. So students, I want all of you to go through your all these side headings and sub headings and go through all the meanings and advantages, disadvantages and everything. Don't waste your time. Finish all your 3 lessons, chapter 1, chapter 2 and chapter 3. So now we have completed unit 1 and under unit 1 we have seen first one, that is principle of management, functions of management, management by objectives and management by exemption. So we have completed management process. From next class onwards we move on to the next unit, that is fourth chapter, that is financial markets. So be clear with these sessions. Thank you students.